Good morning. How's everyone doing? Good. Today I want to tell you a story. Actually, Jesus told a lot of stories. He called them parables. And the story I want to tell you is actually from the gospel lesson for next week, because next week is Communion Sunday. And because it's Communion Sunday, we won't have a children's message. So I want to talk about it today because it's very important for all of us. You know, there once was a young man and he had an older brother, and this young man lived with a very rich man. And the young man had a very nice house to live in, and he had very easy work to do. But this young man, he wanted to go out into the world and live according to how he wanted to live. So he took all of his money that his father would give to him, and he went out into the world, and guess what he did? Do any of you know what he did? He spent all of his money. He spent all of his money on wild living because he loved being in the world. And he loved wasting all of his money. But one day he realized he had no more money. So what did he do? Any of you know? What will you do if you have no money, Owen? You pray, but this is not what he did. That's what he should have done. But instead he got a job. And there's nothing wrong with this. But he got a job feeding pigs. But the problem in those days that when you fed pigs, you had to live with them. You see what that picture shows us? He's not very clean, is he? He's not very clean at all. He is very dirty. Now, you never get that way, do you? You do get that way, okay. Yeah, he's really dirty. He's really dirty with the filth of the world. That's what this means. And that's what happens when we leave the safety and security of the church, our Father's house, and we go out to the world. Because in the world out there, it's very dirty, it's very evil. And when we start living with the pigs, we will become just like the pigs. And that's what you see here with the man, don't you? He looks just like a pig. He doesn't have four legs, but he's dirty just like a pig, isn't he? So what does this young man finally do? What do you think he does? Yeah. He prayed. You're right, Owen. He actually did pray. He decided that he would repent of his sins and he would go back to his father. And it's the same way today. People can repent of their sins and come back to the church and they will be forgiven. So what's the story? What's behind this story? Why is this important for us? It's important for us because sometimes, yeah, it's all about Jesus. You're right. Sometimes in this world, you'll be tempted to go out and live like everyone else in the world. But when you live like everyone else in the world, in God's sight, you are this. You are a dirty, filthy pagan. You're a dirty, filthy unbeliever. And when God comes on that last day, he won't see a clean man who's been washed in the waters of baptism and been forgiven of his sins. He'll see a dirty man who won't go to heaven. But all of you have been baptized right over there, and you have been, and you have put on Jesus. In Jesus' eyes, you have all been forgiven of your sins, and you're his dear children. And when he comes on the great last day, he will see you as his child. And on that day, you will be saved. So be careful about people who say that you must live like the world lives. No. We live in the way that Jesus tells us to live. We come to church, we hear his word, and we hear that all of our sins are forgiven. Very, very good. Let's fold our hands and close our eyes and let us pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for being our Savior. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for washing us clean in the waters of holy baptism. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that you have died for us, and that when we become people who wander away from you, you come searching for us, and when we come back, you come running to us and forgive us of all of our sins. Lord Jesus, we pray that you be with these children this week, that you guard and guide them, and that you continue to watch over them, O Lord, for they are your dear children. And all of this we pray in your most holy name. And all the children said,
Amen.